before we start, let me ask, does anyone know about this one? Anyone? What's this one? Right? Yes, please tell us. Anyone else? Because the most famous application of blockchain so far is Bitcoin, so. So basically, what Bitcoin is a cryptocurrency that's based on the blockchain. You can call it the father of crypto, because every other cryptocurrency is forked from the Bitcoin blockchain. But today, our focus today is not Bitcoin. Our focus today is Bitnation and Pangea. This is the new application that's being built. What Bitnation is trying to do is trying to create a sovereign state on the internet. So you can basically have land titles, have marriage titles, birth certificates. Incorporate the business using this application for itself. And Cody Wilson is a famous person. Increasingly, all possible questions that we can find about have been relegated to a non-administrative sphere. So I could spend my entire career becoming one member of some segment of the government, getting outside that cycle for many years, making a career, or I could have software that totally exposed the paradigm. Right, it's a question. So what Bitnation is trying to do is trying to shift the political question of like, we don't have to have a defined territory becomes a state. Like, people with similar ideas and similar visions can come together and form a state using the nation. So our cryptocurrency is called expats and is currently being traded on Banker and LA tokens. So if you have expats, you can exchange them to fiat currencies like dollar and euro. And we also have people here who can exchange it to our country's currency, which is great. Question is, would you like to choose your governance service just like you choose your phone provider? Ironically, in Ethiopia, we can't even choose our phone provider. Yeah, telecom, which is a monopoly. But imagine if we can choose our own governance systems, like there's a third-party entity that provides governance services, sovereign entity. So that's the goal for Bitnation here. So most people think that blockchain and cryptocurrency and Bitcoin is just money, and some people think it's like fake money or it's not real. But blockchain is that's a foundational technology. So it's one of those technologies that comes in a decade or a century that can transform every aspect of the internet. You can call it Internet 2.0. So the Internet 1.0, Internet 1, was basically exchanging information. You can send messages, pictures, videos, and email. You can email people from all over the world. But you cannot exchange tokens with value. Like if I send you a picture, there's a copy left on my server or on my computer. But if I send you money, then it needs to be secure that the money I send is not remaining with me. So that's the one of the problems that blockchain solves. So Internet 2.0 basically is the internet which we can exchange value. Like Bitcoin, like if I send a cryptocurrency, then the servers all over the world, the decentralized servers, make sure that my money is cut from me and given to the other person. So that's what the blockchain does basically. And it's not just for money. It's therefore a brand new governance structure replacing the nation state concept from the Napoleon era. I'm pretty sure you guys are familiar with the nation-state model we're living in. This current state model is, in history class, is called something called Westphalian Treaty, which in which in 1600s, 1700s, nation-states started drawing all their borders. But that's history class, it's not history class, or history. So additional norms, like we know that national borders are imaginary, are global, but most governance systems are still for local polity. So the government marriage system is one of the most obsolete systems today. Marriage is a very personal matter, but being enforced by government and the law are so different in each country. So this is one of the guys using governance oligopoly, the nation state.
You can say America or Ethiopia, which are nation states. So what the current model is not perfect. Does anyone think the current model we have of governance is perfect? Anyone? It's not perfect, right? So what can we do?
So current governance providers don't need to compete in their territory.
For example, in Ethiopia, there's no competition. So if there's no competition, In economics, we learned that competition kind of helps make the service better and increase the quality, right? So if there's no competition, there's no incentive for better service. Why would you be better? There's no competition. So what we have is like some sort of Game of Thrones. Have anyone seen Game of Thrones? So basically, it's what, like a civilized version of Game of Thrones in which people, political parties are created, and then they try to have supporters, and then they become a government. But this paradigm shift in this dimension we're trying to deal with is you don't need to compete to become a government. It can be a third party, like a competition in a sense, and still provide that government service. So this guy is also a famous guy. So I want to create tools that people can use to manage themselves as a society. A conventional law-based system is very weak. For the society we live in nowadays. People with enough money or intelligence can manipulate and use it against society, as we have seen many times. Can anyone give me an example in which this statement applies? Don't you think corruption and all other things, don't you think can be solved with this technology?
For example, if I have terrorists, I could easily access all of these.
Well, that's a very good comment. Well, it's been said that Bitcoin is used by terrorists and for funding and stuff. You're right. But the thing is any technology can be used for good and bad. My example is like a pen. You can use a pen to write good things, right? And you can also use a pen to like stab people. The technology. Well, at the end of the day, the technology you use it for, it's both for the good guys and the bad guys, but for us, we use it for the good purpose. But once the genie is out of the bottle, you can't put it back. Like, that technology is already out there, and the best thing you can do is let like, the good guys win.
So, bad passports. Alright, make it difficult or impossible to migrate. 2 billion adults in the world are currently unbanked. What's a bad passport? Like, I'm Ethiopian, so I have an Ethiopian passport. Do you think my Ethiopian passport has the same privileges as the American passport? You think that's... So that's the current world we're living in. So imagine if we had Bitnation passports, and these passports are recognized by the UN. By the way, Bitnation has won the United Nations UNESCO Net Exploration Award in 2017. This award was previously won by Spotify, Twitter and Airbnb, so the United Nations, we're already working with the United Nations. They won this award by registering refugees. So they register refugees, they give them IDs, wallet address, and all the services, which normally they wouldn't be able to have. So 2 billion adults in the world are currently unbanked. Imagine reaching those 2 billion markets. So even in Ethiopia, most of our citizens, our people are not banked. So it's also a good way to reach people. So if the great economy of the nation, it could be the second largest economy in the world. Imagine, there's America first and there's China second. So the great economy meaning, the not legal ones, like the informal economy, if it was illegal or if it came to the legal side, it would be the second largest economy in the world. So this nation has the ability to reach out to the great economy. For example, even something like the COVID, you guys know COVID, the European formal saving. It's a kind of a great economy. Like, imagine if all the COVID transactions were legal. Imagine the amount of money could bring to the economy. Right? So, in the nation, we have a decentralized app, that's a third party app, trying to deal with the COVID. We're already working on a proposal at the local government COVID provision. So, the ethnicity app is more incorporated in the business now. So, today, the people will all download the app and I'll show you how to create wallet addresses. And each of you will be receiving some cryptographs as well. Before we get to the technicalities, we need to understand the technology behind. So, passports are by no means necessary. Unfortunately, the global apartheid condemns millions of people to stay in their impoverished home countries. My hopes raised in the Bitnation platform, which possibly provides everyone in the world with a unique ID on the blockchain. Be recognized as offshore travel documents by governments. So, does anyone know about the geographical apartheid? born somewhere, you just have to stay there, you get a citizen, right? So that's the joke called apartheid, the first 1.1. So this 2.0 governance is the blockchain jurisdiction. So this is the passports that's currently being designed. So this is going to be accepted by the UN, hopefully. If we hit a critical mass, like all people are interested in, people are using the app, it will be recognized. We currently just released a diplomatic program. You can be a diplomat, like a recognized diplomat. We have released a passport for that. And by the way, citizen passport. Currently, right now, by paying $150 worth of expats, currencies, you can be a diplomat for the nation. With everything covered, like diplomatic immunity, like any other nations. And this is the website, the QR code. And this timestamp is going to be on the blockchain, so no one can, it's immutable. No one can delete you, no one can hack you, no one can like mess up your identity and stuff like that. And with all this information comes your land titles and all other things combined with governance. Marriage contract, will, birth certificates, child care contracts, land titles, and business deals. Can anyone tell me any land title problems in this country that can be solved?